Hello and welcome. My name is Lynn, or LV Handcrafted, on all of the socials. And today I'm here to share with you some new stencils that just hit the shop. I'm going to share three stencils. These are all single layer stencils. So in the set, you will see one Mylar stencil. They are beautiful. You can get a sense for the design here. This is the 6x6 spiderweb stencil. Then we have hats and bats. Look how fun that is. And then finally, there is the jack-o'-lantern faces stencil. So look at that. You get a variety of different jack-o'-lantern faces. What's great about these stencils is that they are single layer, so it gives you a lot of options because you can use them this way. You can use them on the back side too, if you'd like, and turn it in any which direction you'd like. So that's one thing that's really great about single layer stencils, because you can really use it any which way. Now, before I show you how to stencil, in case you've never done it before, let me show you what each of these stencil designs look like on an actual panel. So here is the spider web, and I use just some distressed oxide black soot ink. So you can see the Mylar will actually block out what is white here. And so the black soot is what gets stenciled, inked up onto the panel. That's an example of spider web. Here's an example of hats and bats. And here I used two different colors. I used purple for the hats, and that's actually villainous potion, again, a distress oxide. And I used black soot distress oxide for the bats. So you don't have to use all the same color, and you can kind of mix and match. You can go very solid. You can do a little bit more of an ombre. That's totally up to you. And then here's a final example of jack-o'-lantern faces. So this is actually just a bit of a glitter paste. And I had a little bit of fun with this and mixed in some glow-in-the-dark mica. So check that out. This whole panel, those jack-o'-lantern faces, will actually glow in the dark. So just something fun. You don't have to just use your inks. You can use the line of glitter mousses that we have, the various different texture pastes that we have in the shop, or get creative and make your own medium to stencil through the design. So now let me show you how to do some stenciling. I'll show you how I made this panel here. Okay, so starting off, this first step is optional, but I definitely recommend it. So I have my stencil in a box here, and I'm going to use some pixie spray and spray a light coating all over the back of this stencil. Pixie spray is really great. You don't need a heavy spray of it. And what it will do is just add a little bit of tackiness to the back of your stencil so that it helps to secure your stencil onto your project. So here are some basic supplies that you'll need. I've got my stencil. I have my medium, so in this case, distress oxide inks. I've got different stencil brushes here. We have two varieties of these round stencil brushes. There's one that's firm and there's one that's soft. The glitter handled ones are the ones that are soft. And in both cases, the bristles themselves are super soft. It's just that one is more dense and has a more firm feel to it, and the other one has a more flexible feel to it. There's also a set of three angled stencil brushes for some detail stenciling. So this stencil, I've already sprayed my pixie spray on it, so it's got a little bit of tackiness. You don't need anything else special beyond this, but I do recommend protecting your work surface. So I've brought in a piece of just white copy paper, and see how that stencil, it will hold the panel, but it can lift right back off and it won't tear your cardstock at all. Okay, so now with that secured, what I'm going to do is this is the witch's hats and bats stencil, which is perfect to show you a technique where I'm actually going to use two different colors and stencil in very precise areas. So for all of the bats, I will stencil that in black soot. And I like using a smaller brush. It really just depends on how much space there is between the different areas, open areas. So with this particular design, I actually found it quite easy to use the larger brush and not accidentally stencil into one of the hat areas that I'm trying to avoid. There are different techniques that you can use. You can pounce your stencil straight up and down. That might be interesting to get you a more textured look if you'd like. Or what you can do is go in circular motions, and that could give you a more solid look. So it really just depends on the look that you're going for. If you're looking for really full coverage, or if you're looking for a little bit more texture, a little bit more of that stippled effect. And just like that, I have completed my first color. So then I'll go in, and it's easy to clean these brushes and use them over and over again. You just need a little bit of water. And even if the stencil appears to be stained, just a little bit of soap and water will clean out all of the ink. It may leave your bristles a little bit stained, but that won't transfer to your next stenciling. So as you can see here, I'm using that detailed brush that I started with black soot. And now I'm going into Ocean, a really beautiful purple color. And I'm going to go in and get all of those witches' hats in purple. And it helps to have this smaller, more detailed brush because it, I don't want it to accidentally pick up any of the black soot that is on the stencil. So I'll take a moment to really try to get into all of those edges, and with the stencil secured down with that pixie spray, it's really easy to know that I won't actually accidentally stencil underneath or ink underneath the stencil, because that pixie spray is going to hold that entire stencil firmly to my cardstock panel. So my panel is complete. I'm just going to take a look over everything and see if there are any places where I want to go back in for a little bit more of a solid look. So definitely it is easier at this point, before you lift off your stencil, to really take a second look at everything. Make sure you've got it looking the way that you'd like. Of course, once you peel back the stencil, you can reposition it, but I find it's just easier to take a moment and give everything a look. And this part is the most fun, when we peel back our stencil. So check this out. It looks like a hot mess now, but when you pull back that stencil, that pixie spray will lift beautifully. It doesn't leave any tackiness on your card panel, and it won't tear your card panel at all. It just leaves your beautifully stenciled pattern on your card panel. So really, really lovely. And of course, depending on the medium that you use, you do want to clean this off right away. So that's particularly important if you do use something like a texture paste or glitter mousse, because those tend to harden and be a little bit harder to clean off. But look, check this out. I just used a baby wipe to clean this off, and I have a second stenciled pattern just by cleaning my stencil. Now, this is just copy paper, so I probably won't use that, but imagine cleaning this off onto a cardstock panel, and that gives you a little bit of a two-for-one. So just by cleaning off your stencil, you could get a second stenciled pattern, and we all love a good two-for-one, don't we? So now let me show you some amazing projects that the Cat Scrappiness Creative Crew has created, showcasing some of our latest stencils.